First, create a canvas. You can use any UI object that you want to drag, could be an image or button, it's up to you. Now let's create our script. I will name it UI drag. On your script, let's create a public function named startDragUI. Create another function, and name it stopDragUI. Now add a Boolean variable, I will name it startDrag. Now back to our startDragUI function. Change startDrag to true. And on stopDragUI, turn startDrag to false. On your update function, make mif statement, if startDrag is true then we should be able to drag the UI. To do that we should change the position of the UI and equal it to the position of the mouse. And that's it for the code for now. Make sure you have your script on the UI that you want to drag. It's still not working because we are still missing something, and that is the event trigger component. Now add pointer down. Assign the object that has the UI drag script. And choose the function startDragUI. Next, add pointer up and do the same thing with pointer down, except we are going to call the stopDragUI function. Now let's test it. Now let's try to add snapping. So first let's make a vector2 variable called startPOS. And at the start function, we are going to assign to this variable, the first position of our object when the scene started. Now when we stop dragging, our UI should snap back to its original position. To do that we are going to assign the startPOS to our transform position. And now our UI can snap back to its original position. Now you might use this for your inventory, and want to be able to put it on a slot. First I will create the slot. Add a box collider, and change the size to fit the object. Also create a new tag, you can name it anything, I will name it slot. Next, also add a collider to the UI that we are dragging. Make sure they are on trigger. Now let's go back to our script, add another boolean called in use. Add the onTriggerEnter2D function, and inside check if it collides with an object that has a slot tag assigned to it. If it's true, then in use should turn true. Add another function called onTriggerExit2D, and add the same thing except the variable in use should turn false. Next, at the stopDragUI function, add an if statement, if it's not in use then it should snap back to its position. After that we need to get the position of the slot UI, add a vector2 called slotPOS, and back to our onTriggerEnter function, we will assign the position of the slot UI to the slotPOS variable. Back to the stopDragUI function, let's change our if statement, if our UI is in use then it should stay on the slot UI, if not then it should snap back to its original position. Okay, let's try. And it seems like we are still missing something. To be able to detect collision we need a rigid body 2D, turn gravity to 0 and freeze rotation. Still not working, let's check again. Okay, I forgot to add the tag for our slot. It detects the collision but that is not what we want to happen. I had this code wrong, it should be slot POS is equal to the position of slot UI. Now I think everything is done, let's try it again. And there you go, that is what we wanted to do. For the last time, this is the final code. And that is all, thank you for watching.